if you are having dark underarms, if you are worried about it, if you have tried almost all the treatments for that, and if you want to know what the reason could be and what all treatment options you have, please watch this video till end. We are going to discuss in length about everything. I'm your friend Dr. Shail Gupta, and I'm a practicing dermatologist and have been practicing dermatology for past almost 18-20 years. The commonest reason is acanthosis nigricans. It happens because of increased thickness of skin in this area. It can happen even in the neck region or, you know, thigh region. You can see this on the forehead, on the sides over here, on the temples. So you can see it on almost every skin fold. Acanthosis nigricans happens because of insulin resistance. There is a term called peripheral insulin resistance. So what happens? Insulin is a hormone which plays a vital role in glucose metabolism. So in this condition, body has to secrete a huge amount of insulin because there is a kind of resistance which develops at the peripheral side. So even if the body is producing enough insulin, because of resistance, it is not able to do the desired work, because of which body has to produce more and more of insulin. So such people are usually obese, they are fatty, overweight, and they have sedentary lifestyles and wrong eating habits. Many a times it is seen with a condition called PCOS, polycystic ovarian syndrome. This is seen in females, again with sedentary lifestyle and obesity. Besides that, patients who have PCOS, they can have facial hair growth, hirsutism, they can have scalp hair loss, they can have a lot of acne. All these features can be associated with this. So acanthosis nigricans leads to thickness of the skin. Many a times patients come to us and they say, "Doctor, do anything to remove this blackness, any laser or whatever you want." Young girls who are like about to get married, they have this pigment on the neck, underarms and so many other areas, and they want it to be removed. So here the catch is, you'll have to change your lifestyle, you'll have to change your daily schedule, so that you know, you incorporate healthy eating habits, you start doing some physical activity, exercise, take care of your diet. Only then, once you become fitter, only then, you know, the skin thickness is going to get reduced. Lot of people try scrubbing, different type of facials, and you know, they think that this is some kind of dirt which they can remove by scrubbing it out. Any kind of friction is going to increase this pigment. So this is a misconception. Sometimes there is pigmentation on these areas also. That's called macular amyloidosis, as you can see in this picture. Now this macular amyloidosis also is a kind of thing which will worsen in case you scrub. A lot of people do scrubbing and try to remove this. That's not gonna happen again, even in macular amyloidosis. It can accompany some other hormonal problems also. Very rarely acanthosis nigricans can happen in patients who have cancers, but that's a very rare condition. Sometimes because of some oral medicines like steroids or oral contraceptive pills, we can see this kind of pigmentation in the underarm region. Another reason for this can be post-inflammatory hyperpigmentation, where you have any kind of lesion like psoriasis or any eczema, dermatitis, because of which there is secondary pigmentation which is left over that area. There is a fungal infection called pityriasis versicolor that can also lead to pigmented spots in this area. Then this can happen in a condition called lichen planus pigmentosus. There are so many skin conditions which can lead to underarm darkness. Another very important reason is contact dermatitis or allergic reaction to fragrance. People who use deos or who use perfumes, they can have itching, redness, and which can lead to pigmentation in this area. Sometimes this pigmentation can also happen because of use of wax or hair removing creams in this area. So people who are removing hair by using these creams or waxing, they should ideally go for laser hair reduction. That will be more helpful. So general home care tips which you can do: apply a good amount of moisturizer over these areas. Applying coconut oil can also help you. In case you have obesity, in case you have PCOS, you have to take care of that. Healthy lifestyle is a must. Never try to lose weight, because losing weight consists of two negative words: overweight and loss. Always try to achieve fitness. This is totally different ball game. You know, achieving fitness consists of two positive words. Weight loss is always a destination. You achieve that much weight loss and then you regain it. While fitness is a journey, weight loss is a destination. So please understand this difference. There is a very important and good video which I have made on this. The link is given in the description. And please go through this video. This is posted on a separate channel, which is by my name, Dr. Shail Gupta. You can search online, and you know, this is an amazing channel where I put my guided meditations, motivational talks, affirmations, and my music. So please go through this video. This is very important. Then avoid waxing. You can get hair removal done. Laser hair reduction is a wonderful technique, and it can save you from that continuous effort, repeated effort of waxing and all. Avoid deos and you know, perfumes in case you have allergy in this area. Consult a nearby dermatologist to find out the cause, because the cause needs to be treated. Don't use scrubbing, or don't go to parlors to, you know, remove this. That's not gonna happen. Now coming to home remedies, you can use lemon, you can use cucumber or potato slices. They are very rich in antioxidants. They have a good depigmenting role. They are also useful in treating the under eye circles. You can apply aloe vera also. But in case you feel that there is itching or redness after application of any of these things, please don't use it then. Now coming to medical treatment, obviously the cause needs to be found out and then treated accordingly. You can apply moisturizers. The major cream is glycolic acid based cream, 6% or 12% strength, or sometimes in combination with kojic acid and arbutin and other preparations are available. Then hydroquinone based preparations are also useful, but they are not safe for long term usage. Then vitamin D preparations, some retinoid preparations are also useful in removing this pigment. But sometimes these medicines can cause irritation, burning, because this is a sensitive area. So in case you start these medicines after consulting your dermatologist, it's advisable that you apply it somewhere else, maybe just behind the ear or some other area, just to check on the sensitivity part. In case you feel that there is some kind of allergy, itching, report your dermatologist, stop using the medicine. Continuous use of the medicine sometimes can make it dry, the area can dry up, and the area might become little sensitive. So it is a good idea to increase interval between the medication, so apply it at gaps, and upon applying moisturizer along with that, because that will reduce the sensitivity of that particular area. Besides that, there are some peels which are useful: trichloroacetic acid peel, retinoid peels, they are helpful. Then we also do some kind of lasers, you know, NDR Q-switch laser is a good laser which works on pigmentation, breaks down the melanin content. But in case the skin is thick, you know, all these things are not going to help until unless you reduce the skin thickness by getting fitter. Okay, so as far as the treatment is concerned, the commonest reason is acanthosis nigricans. That is because of increase in skin thickness, and in case you don't take care of that, nothing is going to happen. Nothing. So I hope I have answered a lot of your questions and queries in this video. In case something is left, you can ask in the comment section. We'll be very happy to answer all your queries. You can WhatsApp us, you can call us at the given number. You can visit our site www.satyaskinlaser.com. A lot of information is given on this. In case you want me to make videos on your interest, you can just let me know. I'll be very happy to make videos on those topics. And in case you like the video, please press the like button. Share this video with people whom you think might be benefited from this. Thank you very much for watching our video till end. Please subscribe to our YouTube channel for more such videos. Thank you. Love yourself. Stay blessed.